What's better for lowering blood sugar and cholesterol, berberine or dihydroberberine? This is a question I've been getting a lot lately, so let's look at the proof. Now, one of the reasons people ask this question is that they're aware of the fact that berberine has a low bioavailability. For example, in this study where they literally injected berberine into rats, they reported that the bioavailability was less than 1%. And since most people are not injecting berberine, you get the idea, not a lot of this stuff is getting utilized by the body. To get around this low bioavailability, some companies may combine berberine with other substances such as black pepper or medium chain triglycerides or sea lion cinnamon. However, other companies are starting to use a brand new version of berberine. Enter dihydroberberine. Dihydroberberine is often said to be 5 times better absorbed than traditional berberine. And from what I can tell, the claim of dihydroberberine being 5 times better absorbed appears to stem from this study where rats were given both supplements and the blood levels of dihydroberberine were found to be between 3.2 and 4.8 times higher than regular berberine. If we look at the chemical structures of both dihydroberberine and traditional berberine, side by side, we can see that both molecules are remarkably similar. The only real differences you see are the arrangements of a couple double bonds within the molecule. Now, subtle changes could indeed lead to big differences in how each of these molecules work in the body, but the only way to know for sure is to test it. In this clinical trial, researchers wanted to see if dihydroberberine was better than regular berberine at improving blood sugar levels. On 4 separate days, 5 healthy men, yes, 5, are given either a placebo or 500 milligrams of traditional berberine or either 100 or 200 milligrams of dihydroberberine. And I want to give credit where credit is due. This study did incorporate the GlucoVantage version of dihydroberberine. This version is made by a Chinese company called NNB Nutrition. You may actually see this company mentioned on some dihydroberberine supplement labels. So on 4 separate days, they gave the guys either a placebo or the supplements. They then gave them a test meal containing about 30 grams or 1 ounce of glucose. And they measured their blood for up to 2 hours afterwards to see what happened. Results showed that after just 90 minutes, the 100 milligram dose of dihydroberberine was absorbed 6 times better than regular berberine. And it gets better. The 200 milligram dose of dihydroberberine, it was absorbed 22 times better than regular berberine. So that's great. This is more evidence that dihydroberberine appears to have a greater absorption than traditional forms of this supplement. However, what happened to blood sugar? Turns out, no significant differences in lowering blood sugar between dihydroberberine and regular berberine. Furthermore, neither of these substances was better than a placebo either, which is weird, but one limitation of the study, besides it only having 5 guys, is that it may take longer than just 2 hours to see significant differences in insulin and blood sugar. Okay, so much for that study. What's the other proof for this supplement? Well, searching the National Library of Medicine, I only turned up 2 clinical trials of dihydroberberine. The first clinical trial you see is the one I just summarized for you, and the other one involved placing various Chinese herbs, including dihydroberberine, on the skin of people with asthma to see if it affected them. So 2 studies compared to the much larger number of clinical trials that have been conducted on regular traditional berberine. So far, the research appears to show that in humans, dihydroberberine is indeed better absorbed than traditional forms of this supplement. However, whether or not it is more effective at lowering blood sugar and cholesterol levels requires further human study. Thanks for watching. And if this is your first time on my channel, don't forget to subscribe and share this with your friends on social media, because you're not going to find these unbiased reviews anywhere else. I have been investigating dietary supplements honestly for over 30 years, and I don't work for any supplement company or pharmaceutical company. And I'll see you next time real soon.